Do you believe in evolution?
You know, first, I don't know. Clearly, the scientific community is a little divided on some of the specifics of that, and I understand that.
I don't think they are.
No,
I think they pretty much agree.
I don't know how it all happened. I mean, I'm certainly willing to
But it couldn't possibly have been Adam and Eve 5,000 years ago with a talking snake in a garden, could it?
Well, it could have possibly been that.
Come on.
See, this
is my problem. Yeah. You're a senator. You are one of the very few people who are really running this country. It worries me that people are running my country who believe in a talking snake.
You don't have to pass an IQ test to be in the Senate, though.
That was pretty funny.
And a very nice man.
Yeah, he
Senator
is.
Pryor, you know, I hope he's not...
Okay, this film, Religulous, opens October 3rd. It's going to be wide all over.
Oh, yes.
Okay. Here is another clip from the film, Religulous. Watch.
Oh, I left my cell phone, right? Okay. Want to make sure I... Testing, 1, 2. Check, testing.
All right. How you doing, Bill?
God bless you.
Hi.
Seeing you around?
Having no other gods before you, that's not moral. Mm-hmm. There's nothing moral about that. It's just something a jealous god would do.
And it does say that our god is a jealous god.
But your god is jealous? That seems so ungodlike that God would have such a petty human emotion.
He's also...
I know people who have gotten over jealousy.
Well,
let alone God.
There's two sides of the coin. He's a just god, and he's also a merciful god. He can't stand our sin, but he also...
the first five books of the Bible wiping out people.
Well, that's what he chose to do. His ways are higher than ours, Bill.
Maybe our thinking should be higher.
That's a good point.
Now, you better explain, where was that? That man was Jesus, right?
Yes, that was in heaven, Larry.
We
weren't on location, and believe me, it's not easy to get in there. Permits, you think the Chinese are...
You wrong. Especially. I don't think you ever shot to get there.
No, that was Holy Land. That was the amusement park in Florida, in Orlando.
Like Disneyland, Holy Land?
Yes, you never heard of Holy Land?
No, I never did.
I saw
the movie, and
this got young kids. Larry, you take them down there. They will love it. You'll see a minor league baseball game, go to spring training, you'll go to Holy Land. It'll be a fantastic trip.
What do they do in Holy Land?
Well, they have Jesus. They reenact, we show it in the movie, they reenact the March of Tears, but no, I'm getting that wrong. But, you know, where he was carrying the cross and he was beaten by the centurions and then they, you know, crucify him. And
they show you all that.
They reenacted with that man. That was Jesus.
And you interviewed him.
And I interviewed him, yes.
Did you watch the whole presentation?
Oh, yes.
What do you mean?
Yes, well, you know, I mean, this is what they believe. And we, having been to the real Via Dolorosa in Jerusalem... And then this reenactment in America, I was confounded as to which I thought was more commercially crass. It was really a toss-up.
Really?
Yeah, have you ever been to the Via Dolorosa in Jerusalem? It's really the Via Dolorosa Mall. You know, it's very commercialized. Not that that's the worst part of the whole religious problem that
you,
we have.
In this film, you take a tour, you go to the Mormon church, you go to the Vatican.
Mm-hmm.
Did anything alter your thinking? Did anything impress you?
I was impressed with how hard it is to make a movie. And it altered my thinking about ever wanting to make another one. You know, you just have to get up early in the morning and put on makeup. You know, it's endless all day.
You had a great director, though.
Larry Charles was the right man.
He directed
Borat. And, you know, I needed someone who understood comedy, because we're making a comedy. We're mostly trying to make people laugh, but I also would like to arouse the somewhat like 16% of people who I call rationalists. They would call them atheists or agnostics in America. It sounds like it's a small minority, but 16% is actually bigger than blacks or Jews or homosexuals or NRA members or teachers union, Hispanics. If those people stood up and made themselves heard, but they never do.
Do you think it might be more? Do you think there are people who just don't admit it?
Absolutely. You know what they are? There are a lot of people like me, like I was. We'd make a point in the movie to show that my evolution toward where I was, where I am now, was gradual. You know, I still had, later in life, I wasn't a religious person. I definitely didn't believe in the Jesus story after we quit the Catholic Church. But I did have an idea of some imaginary man who lived in my head, who got mad at me if I was bad, and who I had to bargain with if I was bad. And I was always being like, oh, please, God, get me out of this. If you just get me out of this, I promise I will never do this again. So, you know, it doesn't happen overnight. You have to come to it slowly.
I asked Rick Warren if he could would America vote for an atheist? And he said never, because, in his opinion, he could never vote for someone who did not believe in a higher authority than himself or herself.
Well, but see, I used to read parts of Rick Warren's book on stage in my stand-up act. It produced, I promise you, gales of laughter. Because the idea that any person on earth can tell you with such specifics what happens when you die just blows my mind. That somebody on earth, another person, can just say to you, oh, yes, and what happens when you get to heaven? Yes, you'll meet Jesus. He's wearing a white robe. There's a little gold piping on the sleeve. And then you go in this room and you eat eggs and you watch F Troop. Are you kidding? What are you talking about? You're just a person like I am. You are clueless. You have no idea what happens.
Don't you think Rick believes it?
Of course he believes it. But how ridiculous is that? Like, if I went to the Himalayas to find the holiest of holy men in the world who had all the answers, the guru, and I got to the top of the mountain, I said, please, Master, can you help me with the ultimate meaning of life? He'd say, yeah, there's a guy, Rick, in Long Beach, Rick Warren. Go ask him. He knows exactly what happens when you die. And, you know, that is my ultimate message. Unless a god told you personally what happens when you die, it all came from another person with no more mental powers than you have, and you don't know. So just man up and say, I don't know.
But they believe. And belief is a tough thing to counter.
Yes, you know? And I understand why it's a luxury for some people who don't need it, and why a lot of people are less fortunate, and they do need it. So we're not trying to point fingers in this movie. I think we do it. We're laughing all the way through it. I think we're winking and having a good time, and we're not trying to be judgmental. But at some point, you know, mankind is going to have to shed this skin if he's going to move forward. I do have a serious intellectual problem with it. And on another level, it just ticks me off. It's just the ultimate hustle. It's just pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. You know, why can't they? I asked Jesus in this at Holy Land, why can't God just defeat the devil and get rid of evil? You know, and it's the same reason a comic book character can't get rid of his nemesis. Then there's no story. If God gets rid of the devil, and he could, he's all powerful, well, then there's no fear, there's no reason to come to church, there's no reason to pass the plate, we're all out of a job. You know, it's got to go on.
Start dialing, Bill. We'll take your calls.